Buddy, I hope you all are fit and fine and you are doing your work regularly. So in the previous class, we have learned how to divide decimal numbers, right? So today we are going to understand if we divide a whole number by a whole number, then the decimal number will come in the quotient. Let's take one example to understand this. Suppose if I am dividing this 3 by this 2, so how we will divide? We will write 2 in the divisor and 3 in the dividend. Now in the table of 2, 3 never comes, so we'll take 1 time 2 only, and the remainder will be 1. So there is a remainder, but we can make it as a decimal number also. Yaha jo quotient hai, which is showing 1 only, is 1 ko hum decimal mein bhi convert kar sakte. And how? See, if I am writing this decimal point here, this decimal point will allow us to write 10 in the remainder. जो भी यहाँ पे remainder आएगा, उसकी जगह हम क्या लिख सकते हैं? एक साथ में 0 को add कर सकते हैं. Now see, this 2 and this 10 are both divisible, and in the table of 2, 10 comes 5 times. So the remainder will be 0 then, and the answer will be in decimal numbers. So 1.5 will be the answer of this 3 divided by 2. So this means a fraction can be written as a division sum, because agar hum isko solve nahi bhi karte to hum ise mixed fraction mein likhte. For example, this 1 upon 2, this will also make 3 upon 2. This is a decimal fraction only. So this decimal fraction becomes now 1.5 as a decimal number. So we are going to learn about this only. We are going to divide whole number by whole number to get decimal number. Now in this sum, 4 divided by 5, 5 is divisor and 4 is dividend. So we are going to write like this, 5 as a divisor, 4 in the dividend. Now as we can see, the divisor is greater than the dividend. And when the divisor is greater than dividend, that means अंदर जो नंबर है वो छोटा है और बाहर जो नंबर होगा वो ग्रेटर होगा. अगर बिगर है, what we have to do? We have to make it a larger number. इस dividend को हमें क्या करना है? Larger number में convert करना है. So larger number में हमें जब convert करना होगा, we are going to put a decimal point in the quotient, and this decimal point will allow us to write 0 in this dividend also. हम remainder में भी zeros लगा सकते हैं. और जब आपकी ऐसी situation आ जाए जहां आप dividend को divisor से divide नहीं कर सकते हैं, so you are going to put one decimal point in the quotient part and one zero in the dividend part. So आप dividend में एक zero extra लगा के आप divide कर सकते हैं. Now see, in the table of 5, 40 comes 8 times. So after this decimal point, you will write 8, because 5 times 8 is 40. The remainder is 0 and the answer is 0.8. This 0.8 will be 0.8, because hum 0.8 nahi likhte. Hum kya karenge? Ek extra aage 0 bhi lagayenge. So this 0.8 is the answer. In B part, 12 is divisor and 3 is dividend. Again, the divisor is greater than dividend. Yahan dividend chota hai and divisor kya hai? Greater hai usse. So again we are going to put one decimal point in the quotient part and one zero here in the dividend. Now this becomes bigger one. So dividend is greater than divisor now. Now we are going to divide this 30 by 12, and in the table of 12, 30 never comes. So isse hum ek chota number lenge, and that is 24. So 2 times 24 and then subtract. So 30 minus 24 will be 6. If you will borrow numbers and then you will subtract, you will get 6 only. Now see, there is a remainder. So jab yahan pe again remainder aa gaya hai, what we are going to do? We are going to write 10, because we have already put a decimal point in the quotient part. Humne already decimal point apply kar diya hai. So hum yahan pe ek extra 0 likh sakte, but only one extra zero. If you are going to write 2 extra zeros, so you are going to put 10 in the quotient also. That's why we are going to take only 10, because we have put a decimal point here. So this will become 60 now, And in the table of 12, 60 comes 5 times. So 5 times 60, then subtract, it will be 0. So 0.25 will be answer, and we are going to write it like this, 0.25. This is the answer. So next we are going to divide this 154 by this 28. So 28 is the divisor and 154 is the dividend. I have written the table of 28 here. In this one, we are going to take one less number because 154 isme nahi aata hai. So we'll take 5 times 140. So 5 times 140, subtract 4, 1 and 0. So there will be 14 in the remainder. Now, we cannot divide this 14 by this 28. So we'll put a decimal point here in the quotient and 0 with the remainder. Right? So now this is 140, and 140 comes in the table of 28 5 times. So 5 you will write in the quotient, 140 here, and then subtract, the remainder will be 0 and answer will be 5.5. Question number 2, C part, it is given 18 divided by 125. So we are going to divide this 18 by this 125. So I have written table of 125 over here. So is this 18 cannot divide by this 125 because 18 is smaller than this divisor, right? So we are going to make this a larger number. What we are going to do? We are going to put a decimal point in the quotient and we are going to write 0 with this 18. So this will become now 180, which is greater than 125, greater than divisor. Now see, in the table of 125, 180 se chota number kya aata hai, that is only 125. So one time we will take 125 and then subtract. So this 0 minus 5 not possible, we'll take borrow from this 8. This will be 7 and this will be 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 7 minus 2 is 5 only, 1 minus 1, 0. Again, this remainder is less than this 125. So we are going to write 1, 0, and we have already put a decimal point in the quotient. So 1, 0 jo hai hum already likh sakte. But agar aapko ek extra aur 0 lagana hai, to aap quotient mein bhi 0 lagayenge. So this will become now 550, and 4 times kya aata hai in the table of 125? 500. So 500 we are going to take, 4 times, this is 50 as a remainder again. Again we can write 10 with the remainder, and again we'll take 4 times 500, 0 will be remainder, and the answer is 0.144. This is the answer. In next question, we are going to convert these fractions into decimal fractions, or you can say decimal numbers. So in question number 3, B and E part, I am going to solve here. B part is 1/4. So the divisor is 4 and dividend is 1. And this 1 is less than this 4. Dividend is less than by divisor. So we are going to put 10 here, because jab bhi aise situation aayegi, when the dividend is less than divisor, we are going to make it a larger number. Jo yahan dividend hoga, use hume bada number banana hai. And uske liye hum kya karenge? We are going to put a decimal point in the quotient part. Now this will become 10. Now in the table of 4, 10 never comes. So we'll take a smaller number, 2 times 8. Right? Next, 10 minus 8 is 2. Next is, the remainder is 2. So again we are going to make it a larger number. So point we have already put here. Humne point yahan pe already laga diya hai. So we are going to put 10. We are going to write 10 in the remainder. Now in the table of 4, 20 comes 5 times. So 5 times 20, the remainder is 0, and the answer is 0.25. Similarly in this one, the divisor is 25 and dividend is 1. Again we are going to make it a larger number, So put a decimal point in the quotient part. It will be 10. Now see, this 10 is again less than this 25. ये अभी भी क्या है, इससे छोटा है. So what we are going to do, we are going to write one extra zero, but the situation is changed. है ना, हम ये ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे 10 एक्स्ट्रा लगाया था जब हमने डेसिमल पॉइंट लगाया था. नाउ जब हम एक और एक्स्ट्रा जीरो लगाएंगे तब हम क्या करेंगे, क्वेश्चन में आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट भी हमें एक एक्स्ट्रा क्या लगाना होगा, जीरो. अगेन सी, दिस वॉज 1. सो डेसिमल पॉइंट जब हमने लगाया इट विल बिकम 10. सो अभी भी ये इससे छोटा था, सो हम इसको क्या बनाएंगे, 100 बनाएंगे. सो 100 के लिए आपको यहाँ भी एक जीरो लिखना होगा एंड यू विल राइट जीरो इन द डिविडेंड ऑल्सो. नाउ दिस विल बिकम 100 एंड इन द टेबल ऑफ 25 100 कम्स 4 टाइम्स. So it will be 0 in the remainder and 0.04 will be the answer of this fraction. Similarly, you can do question number 3 all parts. Next, we are going to solve question number 4. I am solving B and C part over here. B part is given 5 by 8 and C part is 11 by 16. Again, we are going to follow the same method. The divisor is 8 here and dividend is 5, which is smaller than divisor. So again we are going to make it a larger number, decimal point and zero. So in the table of 8, 50 se chota number kya aata hai 8 ki table mein, 6 times 48, right? And 50 minus 48 will be 2 only. Again this 2 is smaller than this 8, so we are going to write 10. It will become 20 and in the table of 8, 20 से छोटा क्या आता है, 2 times 16, subtracted again, 20 minus 16 will be 4 only. And now again 4 is smaller than this 8, so again we are going to make it a larger number, put 10 only. So this will become 40 now and in the table of 8, 40 comes 5 times, so this will be 40, remainder is 0 and the answer is 0.625. This will be answer. Here in the next part we are going to divide this 11 by 16. Again this is a smaller number, so we are going to make it larger number by putting 10 and by putting one decimal point in the quotient part. Next this will become 110 now, and now in the table of 16, 110 never comes, so we'll take 6 times 96. Now subtract it, 0 minus 6 will not possible, you will take borrow from the other number, this will become 10. So 10 minus 6 is 4, 10 minus 9 is 1, it will be 0. Now this is 14, so 14 is again less than 16, again we'll put 10 because we have already put a decimal point in the quotient part. So this will become 140. Now we will take 8 times 128 because this one is the last number by 140 in the table of 16. Again 0 minus 8 not possible, take borrow from this 4, 10 minus 8 2 and this will be 13, 13 minus 12 is 1. So now this is 12, again we'll make a larger number, so this is 120. And now we're going to take 7 times 112 in the table of 16. Next, 0 minus 2 is not possible, so we'll make it 10 and this will become 11. So these will be zeros. Again, we'll make it a larger number, that is 80, by putting 10. And in the table of 16, 80 comes how many times? 5 times. So 5 times 80. The remainder is 0 now. So the answer is 0.6875. This will be answer. In question number 5, it is given 2 upon 20. So for 2 upon 20, 20 is divisor and 2 is dividend. Again, this 2 is less than this 20. So we'll put a decimal point in the quotient. Now it become 20 and in the table of 20, 20 comes one time only, so one time 20 and then subtract
remainder is 0 and the answer is 0.1. This is the answer. Now in the next part, C part, it is given 13 upon 50. So 50 is divisor and 13 is dividend. 13 is less than 50, so we'll make it a larger number by putting a point, decimal point in the quotient. It will become 130. Now in the table of 50, we'll take 2 times 100 because 3 times 150 aata hai. So we'll take 2 times 100 and then subtract. It will be 30 as a remainder. Now we have already put a decimal point in the quotient, so we can write 10 in the remainder. Now this is 300, and in the table of 50, 300 comes how many times? 6 times. So 6 in the quotient and subtract 300. Now the remainder is 0. So the answer is 0.26. Similarly, you can solve other parts. Now in question number 6, the sums are given in mixed fractions. So we will change it into improper fraction first. So 4 into 1 is 4 plus 1, 5. So 5 by 4 will be fraction of this mixed fraction. Now we are going to divide this 5 by 4. So 4 as a divisor and 5 as a dividend. So we'll take 1 time 4. Remainder is 1. Now we are going to put a decimal point. Now this will become 10. And 4, 2 times will take 8, then subtract, remainder is 2. Now we have already put a decimal point in the quotient, so hum 1 0 extra laga sakte. Now 4, 5 times is 20, remainder is 0. So the answer is 1.25. This is the आंसर. सो जब भी आपके मिक्स फ्रैक्शन होंगे उसे आपको पहले इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन में चेंज करना है एंड देन यू कैन डिवाइड. नाउ इन सी पार्ट इट इज़ गिवन 9 3 by 8. सो अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू चेंज इनटू इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. इट विल बी 8 टाइम्स 9 72 प्लस 3 75. सो दिस विल बी 75 by 8. नाउ we are going to divide this 75 by 8. So in the table of 8, 75 never comes. So we'll take it as 9 times 72. Then subtract. It will be 3, 0. Now we are going to put a decimal point. It will become 30. So in the table of 8, 30 never comes. So 30 se chota kya aata hai? 3 times 20. 4. Again subtract. It will be 6 because 30 minus 4, 24 is 6. Now again we are going to write 10 and 8 ki table mein 60 bhi nahi aata hai. So 60 se chota kya aata hai? 7 times 50, 6. Again subtract. So 60 minus 56 is 4 only. Again we are going to write 10 and 40 kitne times aata hai? 5 times. 5 times 40. The remainder is 0 now. So the answer is 9.375. This is the answer. Similarly you can do other parts. So children, this is your homework. You have to do question number 1 ABCD part, question number 2 A and C part, question number 3 AD part, 4 BD part, 5 AB part, 6 BC part in your notebook of exercise 10G, and rest sums are for practice in your rough notebook. And you have to omit exercise 10H and you have to prepare exercise 10A and B for test that will be taken on Tuesday on 12 January. Thank you.